So, for this transformer, linear dimension of core are double, while the number of turn are half on both HV and LV side. If the transformer is now connected to 800 volt and 50 hertz on its HV side, then its flux density would be. This is the simple question. And now come to the solution. We put the values in the EMF equation as provided here. So after putting the values, B1 and B2 equals to 1.2 Tesla. Now come to the question number 8. For a core type power transformer, both primary and secondary winding have circular coil section, because this section, option A, is easier to wind. B option B require minimum conductor material and therefore less I square R loss. And C has the strongest mechanical shape. D option result in less core material and therefore less core loss. Now come to the solution. Due to the high magnet restriction in a core of a transformer, we provide coil in a circular form for high mechanical stability. In a core limb, we provide the coil in a circular manner to provide more mechanical stability. Due to the force of magnet restriction in a core, this magnet restriction produced due to the high magnetic circuit in a transformer. So due to this, we provide in a circular manner to provide mechanical stability. So the option C is correct. Now come to the question number 9. Transformer action require A. Constant magnetic flux, B. Increasing magnetic flux, alternating magnetic flux, and D is alternating electric flux. Now come to the solution. At no load, we provide EMF at a primary of a single phase transformer, then it set up a flux in a core, that is phi m. Now after we load the transformer of the secondary winding, then IS current flow in a secondary coil of a transformer. This IS current produce a flux phi s in opposite direction to the phi m, that is main flux. Due to this, phi s current is also introduced in a primary coil. So the primary current IP is increased to IP plus IS. This IS current produce a more flux in supporting with phi m in opposite direction of phi s. Due to this, overall flux is constant, that is phi m. So here, this flux is produced due to the IS in secondary coil, and this is the phi m that is normally in at no load. So, and this is produced due to the IS current in a primary, that is increased due to this current. So overall flux in a transformer core is constant, that is phi m, that is known as transformer action. So due to this alternating, so this will happen. So the when alternating magnetic flux is provided at a primary of a transformer. So the option C is correct. Now come to the question number 10. This is a simple question. We all know about this answer. That is the EMF equations, and it's so the E1 by E2 equals to N1 by N2 equals to I2 by I1. So the option A is correct. If you have any queries regarding this any question, then you meet me in comment box. Okay, this video is made by me, Tejan Dzangid, and if you like this video, then it's like, and if you it helpful for you, then it share it. If the response of this video is good, then I will make a second video in a few days. So thank you for watching. Thanks a lot for listening. जय हिंद, जय भारत।